Welcome to Let's Evangelize. The takeover of me. And now we're taking a photo of you.
All right, so we found that footage when just going through the GoPro. So I'm not entirely sure. Anyway, not sure what that says about me.
Welcome, welcome, welcome.
I don't know. I don't know. Anyway, welcome. Welcome. I'll put the pool in the background so it looks nice. Welcome to another episode of It in a Van. Guess what?
We're leaving.
We're leaving Broome. Finally. We're supposed to leave last weekend, but we're leaving in a couple of hours. That's it. Done, dusted, no more. So
Until next time.
But we're coming back because we love this place. We'll probably buy a house here one day because it's amazing. But anyway, so this episode, we just wanted to do, there's been a bunch of stuff that we've sort of had random films of places that we've been to, and I'm just going to pop it all into one episode. So we've got the World War II wrecks out in front of Main Beach, Roebuck Bay, what else? Roebuck Bay, and we drove up to Willie Creek on Cable Beach. That was amazing. I think that's it. There's probably some other stuff, but I'll talk about it later anyway. So, and also I'll probably chuck in some shots of Broome Caravan Park because we really like it here. We've been here for quite some time. So anyway.
It's a broom show.
It's a broom closet. What? Oh, God. I don't know. Anyway, enjoy.
10 to 6.
So it's 10 to 6 in the morning. We've got everyone awake. It is just, I've had a coffee. I think we missed the tea. Oh, peacocks. Cool. Look at the peacocks, guys.
Peacocks.
Awesome. Just there. And we are going to, it's a low, low tide this morning. So it's like 0.5 meters or something like that. So it's extremely low. And there are some World War II ship and boat wrecks that are about a K out from Town Beach. So we are gonna go and try and find them. So yeah, wish us luck. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. How are you feeling, Tarns? So, we went to what was the restaurant called?
Wildflower.
Wildflower. Went to Wildflower last night, which is a really nice restaurant in Broome, and they had a really impressive cocktail list, and Tanya tried all of them. And then we got back to the caravan park and kicked on with some friends. So I'm actually not feeling too bad. But Tanya is rusty. Oh, look, she's not too bad.
I'm not to my pants.
But anyway, so today, just going for a bit of a cruise down Cable Beach. So, interestingly enough, it is exactly 2 months to the day since we actually did our last little kicking back on Cable Beach, you know, when we first got into Broome and saw the camels go past. Little did we know back then that 2 months later we'd still be kicking around here, which is, I think this place has got its own little charm to it. But anyway, we haven't actually gone up Cable Beach yet. So hanging out with Matt and Ali, Doodalux guys, and we're going to go for a bit of an explore up Cable Beach, have a look around the place, do some four-wheel driving, got the fishing rods in, but I don't know what fishing would be like. Maybe even make it all the way up to Willy Creek along the beach. Don't know if you can get past Coconut Wells though, because we haven't done that either, which we'll do probably next high tide. Maybe later on in the week. So yeah, without further ado, let's go check out the extended part of Cable Beach. What you doing, Davey?
Climbing. And
just make sure it doesn't break. So from Cable Beach, you can drive all the way up to Willy Creek, which is behind me. And look at this. I mean, is that not magic, or is that not magic? So it's only a 6 meter tide today. If you are going to attempt to come out here, because like people lose their vehicles out here because of the tides, because this whole area gets washed away when there's a high tide. 6 meter tide today, and the high tide was at about 9 o'clock this morning. So it's still on its way out. There's not gonna be another high tide until late this afternoon. So if you are gonna come out here, just always check the tides, because if you don't, then you could be in all kinds of strife, because yeah, people do lose vehicles out here. Anyway, we're gonna go for a swim. This is bloody beautiful. Unbelievable, just paradise. Just paradise, look how blue that is. Time for a swim. So, this is the reason why you do these trips with someone else and you know your tides. Because this looks like a 200 series Land Cruiser. It was a 200 series Land Cruiser, and it looks pretty trashed, but then you look at the tyres. And that tyre's still reasonably new, so this has probably only been here for a few months. But, yeah, makes you, I think it's been torched. I'd say some of the locals probably came up and set it on fire, but, oh man, that's one way to ruin a holiday. Oh my God. Could you imagine? You know, tides coming up and the car's bogged. Interestingly enough, there's another car over there that appears to be bogged, and there's no one in it. So who knows? But apparently there's a little fishing spot up here that we're going to check out. I think the tide's going to be a bit too low.
Steering wheel.
Eli's just got a steering wheel. Where are you going to drive it, Eli? Do you reckon it'll turn over? Whoa, God. Yeah. Definitely was a 200 series. But yeah, mouth of Wiley Creek sounds a bit soft. Let your tyres down. All good. Anyway, keep on exploring. Just be able to go really, really slow. Hopefully this isn't going to go bad, but it's steep. Here we go, you ready guys?
No, I didn't even...
Oh, I'll tell you what, just...
Whoa! Holy shit!
Holy! Oh! I think we almost rolled. Oh, God. Oh, I hope Tan's got that on tape. Hey, check this out. So about probably half an hour, maybe 45 minutes, heading out towards Coconut Well is the other side of Wheelie Creek. So you can drive here all the way from Cable Beach. You just gotta watch the tides and whatnot. But you get this awesome little fishing spot. So if you look here, it just drops straight down. So I can see birds, I don't know if you can see them up there, there's birds diving in the shallows, probably just picking up bait fish and whatnot. So Matt and Ali are coming here soon. So we're just gonna, and there's spots all the way along here. I think it's called Flat Rock. So it's on the other side of the Pearl Farm. And it's a cool little spot. So we're probably gonna pick one of these flat rocks along here and have a bit of a fish, and I probably won't catch anything, but we'll see how we go. Little fisher, she looks good fishing too, so you know what more can I ask. I probably could ask for some fish myself actually, but anyway, we'll keep fishing. It's a lovely day, a bit windy, but keeps the temperature down. Nice job, Tarns.
Thanks.
A lazy 20 minutes, easy drive, no real full driving needed. outside of Broome is Coconut Well. Now, there's two parts to Coconut Well. There's the first bit that you'll see, which is the lagoon, where you can actually, you go out there on low tide, has to be 9 meter plus tide, and then you can come all the way in the lagoon. So we did that earlier and I got some footage, so I'll pop some of that footage in later on. And we also, once you've done that, another time or same time, depending how motivated you feel, you take the little four-wheel drive track up, depending on where the tide is, and you come up to these sort of rock pools out here. And it's just, it's like some bizarre moonscape. It's just beautiful, and the reflections off the water are amazing. We've come here sort of just before sunset, about 5 o'clock, and you want the tide to be, it's probably a bit low now, but you want it to be about 4 meters-ish, or maybe 5 to 4, just so you can see the tide with a bit of low wind, and you just get this just bizarre moonscape, and these gorgeous little rock pools. So yeah, Coconut Well. Let's check it out. Oh, and there's a mango tree farm on the way through with some mangoes over the edge that you could probably borrow if they're on the public land. But anyway, Coconut Well. Here we are. We are at the mouth of Coconut Wells. And we're in about half a foot of water. And we're hoping that the tide's going to come in.
Yeah.
But
it's, I think, warm.
It's warm, but I just walked down to the I just walked down to the mouth, and the tide is definitely on its way in. So it's just a matter of those walls just behind us, the waves will start coming over there, and then this whole area will fill up and we will float down the majestic blue lagoon. And it will be lovely. It will be romantic. It'll be something out of Blue Lagoon. That the gratuitous.
Do you drink cocktails?
No. No. No, I didn't. That's it. I'm gonna have to go back. Anyway, hopefully we'll be floating next shot. Hopefully. Hello, my man.
Hello.
How you doing?
Good.
Good. Are you floating?
Yeah.
Down the wells?
Yeah, no.
No? Apologies about the water on the GoPro, but in true preparation style, we brought no food and no water. So Toby has just cracked it. And now, check out the mummy taxi. So Tarns gets the to float down the Coconut Wells with the child asleep on her belly. Ah, mums, respect. So I'll tell you what, if you are around Broome, you have to come down to Crab Creek. Well, it's the Bird Observatory, and have a look. Like, it's just, look at this. So my sunglasses broke. You see this? That just happened just before. So I tried to tape them and it failed completely. So I'm gonna have to go home and get some more sunglasses because it's super bright. But anyway, that aside, look at the colour of the water. So this is high tide. So you want to come out, head out towards the Bird Observatory. It's on Crab Creek Road. And you basically, you come down Crab Creek Road and there's all these little turnoffs. And at the high tide, when you've got a 9 metre plus tide, the colour of the water, like we'll come down, the colour of the water is just unbelievable. And you know, you'll hear me go over and over again, probably on the 1,000 billionth Broome episode, talking about how the contrast of the red and the blue and the green and how beautiful it looks. But out here, it is just next level. And it's only 20 minutes outside of Broome. And because you've got that beautiful red dirt and then you've just got, sorry about the wind, these... It's just postcard. It is absolutely postcard. The turquoise blue of the water is next level. So I'll pop the drone up and you'll, if I haven't used some shots already, you'll see them. But we're just gonna have a bit of an explore around here. We might even head down to Crab Creek because the tide's really high. Maybe have a fish, maybe not. We'll see how we go. But no, this is stunning. Hot, but stunning.
Beautiful world, take your time with me, can't you see? You and I must be everything, and be it fearlessly. for.